मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट 2 चैप्टर 1 सिमिलैरिटी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द रिवीजन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 1.2। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस। फॉर प्रैक्टिस यू नीड रिवीजन। सो टुडे वंस अगेन आई हैव स्टार्टेड माय रिवीजन वर्क। वी आर डूइंग द रिवीजन of chapter 1 similarity exercise 1.2. Before starting exercise 1.2, let us review the following basic concepts which are related with this exercise. Your first concept is of BPT, basic proportionality theorem. In BPT, a line is parallel to one side and it intersects other two sides in point P and Q. That means you are getting the ratio of the other two sides, means AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. This is called BPT. Now converse of BPT. Converse of BPT is what? When these two ratios are equal, when it is given, two ratios are equal, that means this line L is parallel to side BC. This is called converse of BPT. And in BPT, line L is parallel to BC, it is given first. And then you have to find the ratio. Okay. Second concept is of intercept made by three parallel lines. AB is parallel to PQ. PQ is parallel to BC. These three lines are parallel. So, intercept made by three parallel lines means you will get AP upon PD is equal to BQ upon QC. This is called intercept made by three parallel lines. Third concept is of angle bisector theorem. The angle bisector theorem, triangle is given to you and one bisector is given. So, you can take like house type, you can take PQ upon PR is equal to QS upon SR. Like this ratio you have to take for the angle bisector theorem. Okay. Now we'll come to exercise 1.2, sum number 4 solution. Diagram is given to you. In triangle ABC, you can see angle APQ is 60 and angle ABC is given 60. You want to prove that AP upon PB, this ratio, AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. You want to prove this. So it is very easy sum. Here it is given angle APQ is equal to angle ABC equal to 60. These two are given. So I have written here given. That is angle APQ is congruent to angle ABC. It is given equal. We have to show incongruent. But which type of angle they are, you can easily come to know. But these are corresponding. These are corresponding angles. Very easily we come to know these are corresponding angle, and therefore set PQ is parallel to side BC by corresponding angles test. By corresponding angle test they are parallel. PQ is parallel to BC. So now again in triangle ABC we'll write set PQ is parallel to side BC as we got here, and directly we will get this ratio here. Therefore AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Directly we'll get it BPD. This is called the BPD. And the sum is over. Come to now sum number 5 of exercise 1.2. Again the diagram is given to you. You can see the three parallel lines. Very easy sum it is. AP is given 15, PD is 12, QC is 14, and we have to find out DQ. So here I will write AP upon PD is equal to BQ upon QC. Reason will be congruent intercepts made by three parallel lines. Intercept made by three parallel lines. Or you can write BPD also. Now we put the value here. AP is 15, PD is 12, BQ don't know, and we have to find out QC. And therefore QC is equal to, sorry, QC is given 14. BQ is equal to 15 into 14 upon 12. 3 1s are 3, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 2 2s are 4, 2 7s are 14, 7 5s are 35, 35 upon 2 means you will get the answer 17.5. The value of BQ will be 17.5. And therefore, BQ is equal to 17.5. Okay, now we'll come to sum number 6 of exercise 1.2. Again, the diagram is given. From the diagram itself, you will come to know it is very easy sum. It is based on which concept easily we know. It is based on property of angle bisector, or you can say angle bisector theorem. So I will write here, in triangle MNQ, this is given, in triangle MNQ, sec NQ is the bisector of angle MNQ. Therefore, how to take the ratio we know? This is a bisector from here. So how step we will take? MN upon NQ is equal to NQ upon QP. NQ upon angle bisector theorem. Now just put the values. MN value is 25. NP is. NP is 40, NQ is 14, and QP we have to find out. And therefore QP is equal to 40 into 14 upon 25. 5 5 is 25, 5 8 is 40. 14 into 8 is 112 upon 5, we will get the answer 22.4. So answer for QP is 22.4. Okay, now come to sum number 7. Sum number 7 diagram is given. You can see the three parallel lines AB, BC and EF. These are the three parallel lines. So intercepts made by three parallel lines. We are going to use the concept of this. So here AB is parallel to BC is parallel to FE, and therefore you will get BD upon DF is equal to AC upon CE. Now we will put the values. Here BD value is 8, DF is 4, AC is 12 and CE is X. We have to find the value of X first, and then we have to find the value of A afterward. So therefore X is equal to, very easy sum it is, 12 into 4 upon 8. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, reduce, 2 1s are 2, 2 6s are 12. X is equal to 6. Here we got the value of X, that is CE. CE is equal to 6. Now, we want the value of AE. AE is equal to AC plus CE. A dash, C dash, E. Collinear points there. Therefore, AE is equal to, AC is 12. 12 plus 6. And therefore, AE is equal to 18. We got the answer, AE equal to 18. Okay, now come to exercise 1.2, sum number 10. This is activity sum. this sum has come in now, 2020 board exam. This is a very easy sum and very important sum. Now you can see diagram is given to you. We have to fill the boxes, activity boxes. So here to prove that sec PR is parallel to sec DF, this we have to prove. So proof in triangle XD. So where is triangle XD? You can see a triangle XDE. This is your triangle XDE. Okay, in triangle XDE, PQ is parallel to D. It is given here. So I will write here given. G means given. Okay, given. So what help you will take now? You will take the help of BPD. So this is parallel, so we will take the help of BPD. So XP, we can see here, XP upon PD is equal to Q is given. So you will write here XQ, right? XQ upon QD, BPD. We will take the help of BPD. Now second, in triangle XEF, this is given XEF, QR is parallel to EF. These two are parallel. Again, we will take the help of, this is given, again we will take the help of BPD. So XQ upon QE is equal to XR upon RF. Reason will be BPD. Now from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, what you can see from 1 and 2? You can see here XQ upon QE. Here also you can see XQ upon QE. This both are same. So automatically you will get XP upon PD. XP upon PD is equal to XR upon RF. So where is XP upon PD? Now just take it. XP upon PD. See, it is here. And XR upon RF. You can see here. XR upon RF. So these two ratios are equal now. So these two ratios are equal. That means you will get sec PR is parallel to sec DF by converse of BPD. So this sum is over. Very easy sum it is. Just you have to fill the boxes. Okay. Now we will come to practice test exercise 1.3. Exercise 1.3 is based on test of similarity. Now in test of similarity, you have three tests. One is side angle side test of similarity. Second is side test of similarity. And third one is angle test of similarity. Out of these three tests, most important test is angle test of similarity. This is most important test. Okay. 99% sums are based on angle test of similarity only. So in side angle test of similarity. Now similarity is different from the congruency. In congruency we show the parts congruent. But in similarity we have to show the ratio equal. Now for example side angle. So you will take AB upon PQ. This ratio first. AB upon PQ. This ratio. Then you will take BC upon QR. Both the ratios must be same, equal. And then one inclinal angle is there. So you will get side angle test of similarity in like this. Now for side, all the three ratios must be equal. Means PQ upon AB, this ratio is equal to, it must be equal to QR upon BC. This must be equal to PR upon AC. So when all the three ratios are equal, then only it will come in side test of similarity. And third one is angle similarity. So in angle similarity, you have to show two angles congruent. So when the two angles are congruent, when you will show two conditions, automatically you will get angle test of similarity. Okay, so 99% sums are based on angle test of similarity only. Okay, so come to sum number 1 of exercise 1.3. Diagram is given to you. Now we have to show the two triangles, which two triangles are congruent by which test. So from the diagram itself you come to know this angle CDE is 75 and angle ABC is 75. So one angle is congruent. So as I told you, 99% it is based on angle-angle test. So one condition we got this. And second condition will be here common angle. You can see this angle is common. Angle C is common. Angle C is common for this triangle also and this triangle also. So second condition is common angle. So both the triangles will be similar by angle-angle test of similarity. Now triangle name I will take in triangle DCE. In triangle DCE and triangle BCE. In triangle DCE, first I have started from D here. So second time I will start from B, BCE. Now two conditions we have to apply. Very easy sum it is. Two conditions. First condition, angle CDE is congruent to angle CBA. Each 75 degree. Second condition, angle C, this angle. Angle C is congruent to angle C. Common angle. Two conditions are over and therefore I will write triangle DCE is similar to triangle BCA by angle test of similarity. Angle test of similarity. Now when two triangles are similar, now we can take sides in proportion. If we want, we can take sides in proportion. Now how to take sides in proportion, that also I will show you in this. DC upon BC is equal to CE upon CA is equal to DE upon BA. These are called corresponding sides of similar triangle. We don't want this now. In this sum, we don't want this. But when two triangles are similar, we can take sides in proportion in this manner. If the triangles are not similar, we cannot take this. So now we don't want this. So just I will rub. Only you have to keep in mind. Sum is over.
Go.
Okay. Now come to sum number 2 of exercise 1.3. Now this diagram is given to you. Now we have to show two triangles similar. Now from the diagram itself you come to know that we have to show the sides in proportion. If the ratio of the sides are equal, that means both the triangles will be similar. By side test of similarity. So first of all, we will check the ratio of the sides. So I am writing here PQ upon LM. PQ upon LM. PQ is 6, LM is 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. 2 upon 1. This is the number I will give, 1. Second ratio we will check, QR also. QR upon MN. QR is 8, MN is 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Again you got 2 upon 1. Again third ratio, PR upon LN. PR upon LN. 10 upon 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. Here again you got 2 upon 1. So from 1, 2 and 3. From 1, 2 and 3. You can see all three ratios are equal. As I told you, PQ upon LN is equal to QR upon MN is equal to PR upon LN. So all three ratios are equal. That means triangle PQR is similar to triangle LNN by which test you know now very well. It is by side test of similarity. Side test of similarity. So when the values are given, we have to check the ratio of the sides. Okay? Okay, now come to sum number 3, solution, exercise 1.3, diagram is given to you. These are the two poles and these are the shadows. Pole PR, shadow is QR, and for pole AC, shadow is BC. We have to find the length of the shadow BC. for this pole. So now you can see the triangles, they are right angle triangle, they are similar. There is no need to prove similar. Directly also you can write here triangle PQR is similar to triangle ABC. Because the shadow cast by the pole is at the same time. So directly also you can write triangle PQR is similar to triangle ABC. Now, when two triangles are similar, you know sides are in proportion. So I will take first PQ upon AB is equal to QR upon BC is equal to PR upon AC. Reason, corresponding sides of similar triangle. Now PQ upon AB we don't have value, so we will cancel this. We don't want this. Now just put the value here. QR is 6, BC is X, PR is 4 and AC is 8. Find the value of X. X is equal to 8 into 6 upon 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 6 twos are 12. Therefore X is equal to 12. Now X is equal to 12 means that is BC is equal to 12. And therefore you have to write the statement. Therefore the length of the shadow cast by the pole AC is 12 meter. Okay, now come to sum number 4 of exercise 1.3. Diagram is given to you and you have to prove that triangle CPA similar to triangle CQB. When you will prove this, then afterward you have to find the value of AC. As you know very well, when two triangles are similar, sides are in proportion. So afterward when we will take the sides in proportion, we will get the answer of AC also. So first of all, we will prove triangle CPA and triangle CQB. So for this, we need angle-angle test. As I told you, 99% sums are based on angle-angle test only. You have to keep in mind. It is very, very important. 99% you can solve the sums. Means you can prove by angle-angle test. So here in triangle CPA and triangle CQB. So where is triangle CPA? CPA. And where is triangle CQB? CQB. So one condition you can see, it is each 90 degree. So I will write here, angle CPA is congruent to angle CQB. This is each 90 degree. One condition is given. Second condition is what now? Second condition you have to see in the diagram carefully. Second condition will be common angle. You can see the angle is common. Angle C is common. So I will write here angle C is congruent to angle C. This is common angle. Two conditions are over. Therefore, triangle CPA is similar to triangle CQB by angle-angle test of similarity. Angle-angle test of similarity. So, these two triangles are proved. Now, two triangles are similar. That means sides are in proportion. So, how to take sides are in proportion? You know, CP, first two, CP upon CQ is equal to PA upon QB is equal to CA upon CB. From this first two, then here first two, then second, third, first and last. This is called corresponding sides of similar triangle. Now, just put the values. What are the values? CP and CQ, we don't want, so we'll cancel. Okay, there is no need to write also. PA is 7. 7 upon QB, BQ is 8, CA, we have to find out CA and CB is 12. By cross multiplication, we can find out CA also. So therefore, CA, or you can write AC also. AC is equal to 7 into 12 upon 8. 4, 2's are 8, 4, 3's are 12. 7, 3's are 21. 21 upon 2. 21 upon 2 means you know very well, 10.5. So answer for AC will be how much? 10.5. Okay, now come to sum number 8. This of exercise 1.3. This is very, very important sum. It has come in board exam many times. So you are given AP upon CP is equal to BP upon BP upon DP. Okay, sorry, here D is there. AP upon CP is equal to BP upon DP. Now we have to prove angle ABP similar to triangle CDP. So proof, in triangle ABP and triangle CDP, you will write first this, then two conditions will come here. So first condition is this ratio. This is directly given. So this you have to pick up from given and you have to write here. So AP upon CP is equal to BP upon DP. This is given. First condition is of these two ratios. You can see AP upon CP is equal to BP upon DP. These two ratios are equal. Directly it is given equal. So directly you can write from given. Second condition will be vertically opposite angle. Angle APB is congruent to angle CPB. This is vertically opposite angles. So two conditions are here over, and therefore triangle ABP is similar to triangle CDP by which test? Now it is not angle angle test, it is side angle side test of similarity. Why side angle side test of similarity? Because these are the two ratios of the side, these are the two ratios and one included angle is there. Okay, now come to sum number 9, last sum of this exercise 1.3. Diagram is given to you. This is given angle BAC, BAC. This angle BAC is congruent to angle ADC. This is given, and you want to prove that CA square is equal to CB into CD. So for that we have to prove two triangles similar. Then you will get the sides in proportion, and then afterward you can get this answer. Okay. Because there CA square is given. CA square matlab CA into CA is equal to CB into CD. So sides are multiplied. Okay. So first of all, in proof we will take in triangle BAC. Same triangle. In triangle BAC and triangle ADC. Two conditions. First condition will be same as given. Angle BAC is congruent to angle ADC. This is given. First condition is given. Second condition you will search in the diagram, which you know very well, that is common angle. Angle C is congruent to angle C. This is common angle. So both the triangle, two conditions are over. So both the triangles, matlab triangle BAC is will be similar to triangle ADC by angle test of angle test of similarity. Now two triangles are similar, sides are in proportion. So sides are in proportion means BA upon AD is equal to AC upon BC is equal to BC upon AC. Corresponding sides of similar triangles. Now out of these three, we don't want this. We want only this. You can see AC and AC. AC and AC matlab you can write AC square is equal to BC into DC. AC square equal to BC into DC. Here we got the answer. Now check with the TPT. In TPT it is CA square. So I will write that is CA square is equal to CB into CD. How it is there in TPT? Same way we have to write in last. We got the answer in this manner here. So after getting the answer in this manner, we will write that is karke, we will write like how it is there in the TPT. CA square is equal to CB into CD. Meaning is same. You can see the meaning is same. Here AC means CA only. Meaning is same. And here the sum is over. Very small sum and very easy sum.